Hi guys, thank you for joining me here. I'm glad all my friends decided to join me. There was a 6.1 earthquake there along the Aleutian Islands, Alaska. I have two monitors. The one on the left is the closest monitor that I could find. And then the one on the right is farther away. So using Google Earth, I want to show you the location of these two monitors. So the monitor on the right is Semisopochnoi Island. The monitor on the left is Great Sitkin Volcano. This one here is Great Sitkin Volcano. And this one on the right is Semisopochnoi. Now, on the Great Sitkin Volcano, let me show you this. We got a lot of harmonic tremors. And like I said, that is an alert level of orange. On the Alaska Volcano Observatory, here we have Great Sitkin. Cleveland is at yellow. Pavlov is also at alert level of orange. And Semisopochnoi is also on alert level of orange. Watch. Now, yesterday, Semisopochnoi had some small eruptions where ash was shot up into the air. But the ash cloud was under 10,000 feet. That was as of yesterday. This has not been updated. Now, Great Sitkin Volcano, as of yesterday, they had observed surface temperatures, which means the magma is getting closer to the crust, and you know, an eruption is going to be happening fairly soon. So going back to Google Earth, here is the location of Semisopochnoi. I'm sorry for pronouncing that wrong. Here's the location of the earthquakes. Here we have the Great Sitkin Volcano. And this is the monitor that is picking up the harmonic tremors. Yeah, take your guess of which volcano it possibly could be coming from. I don't know. But this monitor right here by Great Sitkin is picking up the harmonic tremors. And for some reason, the data is not coming in. I don't know if they're just not allowing it to be transmitted or if the power is going down there. But there's been several smaller earthquakes, but I'll show you. See, no data. Yeah, that was blobs of magma coming in. The earthquake signature shows up, but when I try to go to zoom in on it, yeah, no data. Now, on the monitor that's farther away, here's that 6.1. And because it's farther away and they're probably smaller earthquakes, it's hard to see them. Right there is the blobs of magma that shows up in the signature. Now this is, looks like tectonic earthquakes, which is not surprising for what's going on there. We got the subduction of the Pacific plate going underneath the North American plate there. But you definitely can see one earthquake right there, pointing down, which means it came from the south. This one's up, so maybe to the north. We got another small one there and another small one there. And there's a spectrogram. And then we got a whole series of them marked in red right there. Let me see if I can find it. There's actually like four of them through there, and they're marked in red. Let me pull this across. It looks like right there. We'll go to the spectrogram. So before they upgraded it to a 6.1, when it was a 6.0, there was one felt report on that. The foreshock, the 5.5, they don't have any felt reports, but here we can see we got a thrust earthquake, no tsunami. Now, a thrust earthquake is when one side of the fault rises up or the other side drops down, which can cause a great, you know, tidal wave, but it didn't do this. And you can see how we have subduction. The fault line moved going north. Let me bring this out. This yellow line is the area of subduction. Now, there was another earthquake that they are not reporting. That came in pretty good there at Great Sitkin Volcano. You can see it right here, 1134 and 30 seconds. The other monitor, a few seconds later, but not so good. It is farther away. But they are not reporting this earthquake. Why? I don't know. You see it right there and right there. I will not be able to tell you how large it was because shortly afterwards, less than a half an hour later, that 6.1 came in. So the seismic wave would blend into that one. So this would be the 6.1 on the right. And you can see here, we got lots of magma that was occurring. Yeah, prior to that. Now this one right here is that monitor that's a great distance away. But here on Atkin, Sitkin. This is it, and I'll show you. Let me just make this bigger for you and show you how the magma was just continuing, and look how hot that was. So because of this, yeah, I'm not going to be able to tell you how large it was. Look at all the gases coming up. See, this is the monitor, the data. Yeah, it is not going to show. I hate that. All right, again, this is the Great Sitkin Volcano. And see, harmonic tremors. And then we got an earthquake. I don't know if they reported this one or not. Let me look. They are reporting a 4.3 at 2241. That would have been late last night, Universal Time, over there by Fox Islands. So that would not have been it. Yeah. Blobs of magma with some earthquakes, it looks like, right there. Let me pull this across for you. Yeah, harmonic tremors. And that activity is not being reported. You know, the average wage for a geologist that works for USGS is about $95,000 a year. And they don't do the work. No, they do it like half-ass. They'll give you the excuse that there's so many volcanoes or earthquakes around the world, they can't report them all. But this is large enough where they could have reported it. At least regionally, they could have reported it. This is what it's currently showing. This is that faraway monitor at Shamaya Island, right there. Let me zoom in. And this bottom one is Great Sitkin, And I'll go back another 4 hours. You can see there's a small earthquake there and a lot of data missing, so there very well could be more. Let me pull this over. This is from the stream view. And I'll go back another... let me pull it over again. And I'll go back another 4 hours. So this is the foreshock, the 5.5. Again, the bottom one is Great Sitkin, and that's the monitor that's really far away. And I'll go back another 4 hours. Yeah, look at all the data that's missing. Now if we go up over here, yeah, see, we got some small ones here with small P waves on it. That one's 2. Let me go back. That's it. 1300. Yeah, pretty frustrating. See, we got another one right there. That would be a small one at 540. No, excuse me. Yeah, 540. And we'll go back. Yeah, look at all the data that is not there. Anyways. Yeah, they don't care if you know that they're censoring information or not. They just don't plain care. So that's all I have for right now. If you have any thoughts or comments, please put those down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you very much for your support. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you all. Bye.